Hey everybody, it's Charlie here from Daily Motor, and today we've got the audio system demo of the 2020 Honda Civic Type R. This is going to be an in-depth review. We're going to check out how the sound system works, take a listen to some sample tracks, get out on the road, listen to those tracks while we're rolling, and I'll give you my thoughts at the end. Before we get started, let's hop out and take a quick look at the car. So this is the top dog Honda Civic. Got it here, a little fresh updates for 2020. If you like what you see here, hit that subscribe button. It helps us out a bunch. And if you want to see more on the car, we'll have links in the description to a full review done by the Topher, someone who knows a ton about the Honda Civic Type R and really got to spend a lot of valuable time here. So we'll send you there. We always do these tests with uncompressed, lossless WAV audio files on a USB drive plugged directly into the system, and two high-quality binaural microphones in both of my ears, giving you the most realistic audio system experience on YouTube. We also do the tests with the sound settings set to their factory defaults, so let's take a look at those now. We go up here to Menu, Setting, Sound, a few steps to get there. You've got bass, mid-range, treble, your standard front, rear, left, right, fader, and balance, a subwoofer adjustment, speed, volume, compensation, and DTS neural sound, which is just a little bit of Honda's 360 kind of surround sound settings. So let's go through and sample some of those now. Start of the test with neural surround off, because that's the way that the default settings come, and then we'll try turning it on later on in the test. For audio inputs, I'll go back to audio here. Let's see, where is, shouldn't there be an inputs? It's, there we go, source. Not the most intuitive system. Got your standard AM, FM, Sirius XM satellite radio, Bluetooth, USB with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto support, and some built-in streaming radio like Pandora. So what are you missing? Well, you don't have a 3.5 millimeter auxiliary input jack, and you also don't have a disc player. Not too surprising here in 2020, but still would be nice to have. For volume controls, you finally have a volume knob, which you did not in the original iterations of these Civics. So that's nice, got good detents, good clicks, even if it is a little tiny. You also have volume controls here on the steering wheel. For track selection, you can either use the steering wheel right here, or you can go into the audio menu and kind of touch around. You can pull down the now playing and you get track and folder right there, or you can go back up, kind of manually choose your tracks there. Speaker locations. You do have 12 speakers for 542 max watts here in the Civic Type R. Let's take a look at those. You've got at least a speaker grill here, 1, 2, center, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. Subwoofer makes 10. So I wonder if there are some. I don't think there's any in the deck. I bet you there are actually two speakers in the doors. Yep, because there's the subwoofer. That's 10. I bet you underneath this grill there are two speakers in each door. All right, let's start it up. Get on the road. Thank you. Now that we're up to highway speeds, turn down the music, let you hear what the Type R sounds like at 70. There's a good amount of road noise. You also hear a little bit of that engine exhaust note as well. Not the worst, but also not the most comfortable highway cruiser in terms of noise. All right, let's switch to this next song. We'll turn the bass all the way up, see how the subwoofer handles it. So we got bass all the way up and then separate subwoofer control. Sneak peek there. It just frustrates me because Hondas are really good cars, especially something as special like this Type R, and then you just get these garbage audio systems. The screen isn't easy to use. It's slow. It's cumbersome. It looks bad. This is 2020. I've been in $20,000 Chevys that have better screens than this. Look at that delay just for me to press the home button and those things to come up. That's unexcusable in my eyes. Big long delays. Bad views. The sound quality's trash. I'd be given, objectively speaking, sound quality rating of this is like a 4. it's just really frustrating for the money you're spending on this car and everything else you're getting. They can't make a better stereo system. Objectively speaking, given the cost of this car and it being a hatchback, kind of sport hatchback, that sort of deal, I'm still saying about a 4, 4.5. I know the Volkswagen sound systems sound much better. Even the Hyundai Veloster N system is better than this. And the Subaru WRX. And I mean, that's really saying something, because those are not complex systems at all. So anyway, sorry for being hard on this, guys. I like this car other than that, but it's just frustrating with all Honda sound systems. If you liked the video, check out our other content. Check out the Topher's review on this car. And we'll see you on the next one. I'm Charlie from Daily Motor. And as always, drive on.